You talk about some ornery bulls right here. Make you a little nervous. Get back now. Get back, boys. First job this morning, we got a few teeth broken on the tedder, and we've got more hay to ted today, so we need to repair that, put some new teeth in, and one of the arms got bent, so we need to try to get that heated up with the torch and straighten back out. So that's kind of priority one here this morning. Back in the old days, they used to bale about 20,000 bales a year here and hand load every bit of it, and I can't even imagine doing that. But a funny little saying that my dad always had was that anybody that asks you to help in the hay is not your friend. So I've decided maybe I better try to get this unloaded by myself here this morning. I don't want to make any enemies. It's too early in the day for that. So I thought we'd go ahead and unload this in the hay bin over here. That way that'll free our wagons up in case we would square bale tomorrow. We got the hay unloaded. We're going to go up the road and ted a little bit of hay. And for any of you John Deere fans, we're going to do that with a 1973 model 2030. About 60 horsepower, and we've had it for a lot of years. Bought it used from the local farmer and run the mixer wagon for about 25 years. It's been a dandy. So it looks like the hay up the road, at least part of it, is going to round bale today. So we're going to go ahead and hook up to the rake here, go up and get it raked, and then my dad's supposed to come down and round bale us.
Okay.
end of our farm raking some hay here, and just thought I'd give you a little history of the field that we're in right now. It used to be owned by the Kites, and there was an older lady when I was really little that had a house here in the middle of this farm, and there was a driveway that went right down through the middle of it to her house. I always knew her as Mrs. Fields, that was her name. She lived in the house that Newt Kite lived in, and I don't know if he built it or not, but the house was so old that it was built down on the creek bank, and it was built facing the creek because everybody used to travel the creek. So you're going back pretty far for that. That's one little piece of history there. That's about a 9-acre field here, and of course we've raised corn on it for 40 years nearly, and we just switched over the hay this year, so it looks like it's come back pretty good. The second cutting should be pretty good here. Looks like a good stand. So we're raking it up and round baling the first cutting though, just because we want to get through that second cutting quick, and we'd like to get some fertilizer put on this ground, some soil samples and that kind of thing. So we're going to see how it goes. The weather looks pretty good. The radar looks good. So we're going to finish raking this up. We've got old Boone with me here today. He's a big help, as you can imagine. This tractor cab's not really big enough for me and him both. Looks like we're going to wrap up the day back with the mums here. We're going to do something to them that I really should have already had done, but really haven't had a lot of time and the weather hadn't really permitted it. But we're doing something that's called drenching. And basically, we water in a few different chemicals that treats the roots, fights against fungus, that kind of thing. Just helps prevent problems. And also certain insects, aphids, white flies, that kind of thing. So we drench these in, water them in like this, and I hand water them all. It's a lot slower, but even though they're on dripper, I just feel like I get better coverage. So the last couple years I've started hand watering when I do like a specific type of treatment. So that is what we're going to do here this afternoon and evening, and try to get these all treated. Luckily I'm not seeing many problems yet, but this is just kind of a preventative, so we'll get out there in the field and start in on that.